Everyone, welcome to a new game. This is Promesa, at least that's how I think it's pronounced, although I'm not sure. These are the settings, so English, I haven't touched these or these. I'm not sure what kind of game it is. All I know that it's an indie game that I actually bought on a charity bundle a long time ago. But I never played it, and now it's time to. So, without further ado, let's start. Promesa lasts about 45 minutes and has no save system. Headphones and a dark room are recommended. Well, the shit is, if it's a dark room, I can't see, or rather, like, I don't think my face will show. Like, I don't know. Let me see. See, it's just bad. So, let's go ahead as it is. So, is this a horror game? Can I run? Maybe not. All right. Walk speed. Wait, what? Right. Oh, do I want this window? Shit, I'm not liking this at all. What the hell? I thought it was like a loading screen or something. So this means like immigrants hotel? Jesus. Now that I know it's Spanish, means promise. Should I explore? Okay, these are ghostly outfits. Thank you. this side as light. This is me trying to calm myself down. Because although it's pixelated, it's very, it just makes me very uneasy. But I do appreciate the... Holy shit, the transition is awesome. I was saying that I appreciate the option of allowing me to increase my character's speed. Like, the shift in perspective is really cool. I'm just expecting like jump scares and stuff, because the atmosphere is very eerie. Don't make me cuss a dog, please. Okay, great. Someone's making noises outside. Stop. Stop! They're not gonna stop. I'm sorry if you can hear that on a mic. So I'm under the impression that this is basically the story of a family that had to leave their country. I'm thinking this is supposed to be rain. Oh goodness, am I falling? I don't think I can accelerate this part. I don't have control over it. Slowly falling down. Is this our first house or? Okay, now I have control. slow. That is lit up. Sorta. Don't see where the game wants me to go. Oh! I see, actually. But that was completely accidental. Okay, food. Okay, big family, judging by the amount of silverware. Jesus Christ. Realize I'm supposed to just head towards the train. Christ, okay. This is like a violin, I'm gonna assume. Lots of pictures. More pictures in the computer. I'm a ghost! I kinda expected that though. Wait, I'm leaving? This is where the game started though. Something else, right? a solitaire. Is this them packing up and leaving? This is an invisible wall. There's no way I can get out of here. Well, through here. It's a bit suspicious. I don't know. Do you want to sleep? A little bit of stuttering in there. Oh shit, I'm on the floor. My heart skipped a beat with that sudden transition. Looks like a piano. To make sure everything is okay. Yeah, everything's okay. Sorry about that. Okay, this is invisible wall. That is where I came from. Oh, now I'm walking a little bit faster. Thank you. it says Marluxia or Marluxia if it's Spanish. Like, this is like going through the memories. Basically, of the life they had before feeling the need to migrate. That is Spanish, all bumble, you know, all fumbled up, but it is Spanish. This is just in case anyone watching this isn't sure. Flowers and earth or dirt or trees. There's a bunch of pictures on the wall. Yo, I appreciate this thing here. Family of three. A person or what? Right, house. Things in boxes. Suitcase and stuff. So you don't really want me need to come upstairs. Looks like. The shed. Maybe that door over there. Yeah. Not that door. This is too narrow for, you know, for me to be like, yeah, I'd like to live here. No, I wouldn't. I would not. Alright, so it looks like I don't know, maybe I went to work or did some errands. Or maybe this is my new place, but I don't have it in me to unpack, because okay, never mind, the stuff isn't here. Or am I visiting this place and this will just be empty? There isn't like plants or anything. Well, there's a tree, but okay, yeah, it's completely empty. Okay, that was a lot shorter because the estimate was 45 and I got this under 30. Expecting that in terms of like different routes. let's put it that way. I think that brings a lot of a value to the game. I'm satisfied with just playing the game through once. To be fair, going at this completely blindly, I was under the impression that this was gonna be a horror experience, particularly when it said, you know, this is better be played in the dark, and the very beginning of the game is just gives me a very eerie, creepy atmosphere, and it was very unsettling. Being an indie game, you know, I really can't be, how can I say, I really can't compare it to a lot of games with, you know, bigger budgets, bigger teams. What I want to focus on in terms of positives is the audio is really well designed. And the visual aspect, like, first of all, I feel that there's a mixture of visual styles. Sometimes it's fully pixelated, or there other times a bit more stylized, more animated kind of style. And I think it makes them well. Other thing is, I really, really liked the way that the game plays a little bit with perspective. I think that was a really cool idea and well executed. Like, it's a short game, I think, but I don't know, maybe a puzzle game using the perspective aspect would be cool. That's really what, sorry, I'm yawning like always. Anyways, the thing that they did, that the developer did with the, with perspective, I am very, very, very happy with. Honestly, like, the biggest flaw for me is the walking speed. Even with plus 40%, I think it's what I have. Yeah, plus 40% is still slow as heck. And I understand then that, you know, making it faster would just, you know, like, lower the playtime a lot lower. But I don't even see that as a negative, because if the game has, I don't know, sorry for yawning so much, like, multiple, when a game has multiple routes, for me, the shorter each route is, the better, because that's just, it just decreases the, let's say, how likely it is that you will see each playthrough a chore, just to see, you know, the possibilities, the endings, or whatever. So on one hand, I do appreciate the walk speed. On the other hand, we need to jog, we need to run, come on, let's go, let's keep it moving. That's honestly the only negative aspect I have to say. And I really appreciate that there's, like, the Spanish and then the English. I really like that. 'Cause, you know, it just makes it, well, more accessible to people. Like, maybe they're learning a language and they can, like, compare or something. I don't know. I just really liked it. As I said, I will not be playing more of Promesa. I am happy of having just done one run of this. I got this on itch.io. I will post a link on the description in case you're interested and you want to support the developer as well, and check the game out. Alright, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you soon.